Finally! Someone who wants us to do what we do best! Come on! Let's go kill this Danforth creep!
Find a cure yet, dog killers? You have a cure? No bullshit? I don't believe it. All right, Rangers. I ain't gonna turn down a chance to cure my dogs. But if you're lying to us, you're dead. Hear me?
I would dearly love to cut you up and feed you to our dogs. You
Come
better.
On, Raina. You can make it, girl. I want you to see the man who did this to you. And then I'll kill them. So, Rangers, they tell me you can cure my dogs. Can you raise the dead ones?
You don't know the name? How about the name Bobby? Ring any bells? Of course not. Well, let me tell you a little story. Once upon a time, a boy and his dog lived in Highpool, and one day the Rangers came to town and killed the dog. Oh, they said it had rabies, but does that explain them gunning down the little boy too? Any wonder that when that little boy clawed his way back from the edge of the grave, he vowed to hurt the Desert Rangers worse than they'd hurt him? Well, that only took 15 fucking years. We're a militia now, Ranger. The law in these parts, we're in transition. I'm getting rid of the bad apples as quick as I can. Sometimes the people don't know what's best for them. Sometimes you have to force them into good decisions. That's different. The Rangers are a bunch of dog-killing bullies who don't care what happens to the little people. Okay, maybe forcing people isn't the best way. But how else are you supposed to get them all organized and protected? Ha, that's rich. Me take advice from the Desert Rangers? Why would I want to do that? All right, Rangers, all right. You made your point. I guess we... And if you kill any of my dogs, the deal's off. You're dead.
Raina, she's better already. Amazing. Now, go to the kennel. Rangers, hurry. How you feeling, Raina? Who's a good girl? Who's a good girl?
Yes, sir. A fine-looking bitch, sir.
A man who truly loves his furred brothers would not keep them this way.
Cure my dogs in the kennel? Is that so? Camel.
Sir. Yes, sir.
Phew. All right, then. We're done here. Run on back to old Snakey and let him know I'm willing to talk. I ain't promising nothing, but we'll talk.
brought to you by RSM Enterprises, Inc. Copy, Echo One. Echo, congratulations, Echo One.
These gates, portals, valves, doors are awesome. Big, immense, cyclopean whopper of a place you've got here. This place is technology, circuits, nerve center. Cool.
There you are, Team Echo.
Radio's tuned and ready to call the team in LA. Just talk to Vargas and we can open up
the
cargo.
Rangers, officers, I'll give a more detailed briefing in a moment. What I will tell you now is that we have sent Woodson with Ranger Team Foxtrot to Los Angeles to establish a base of operations. And so how are we coming on that?
Any second, General. Unfortunately, until we connect with the source of that powerful Los Angeles signal, contact with Woodson on the ground will be impossible. Ah, looks like that signal is coming in now.
Thank you, Mer-Captain.
Very good, sir. Chopper One, this is Ethel Mer-Captain at Citadel Base.
Roger, Citadel Base. Reading you loud and clear. And howdy, Snake. It's a beautiful day in Southern California.
How do, Angela?
Roger, General. This is our first flight heading west of Santa Fe Springs, and so far it's more of the same. Just like yesterday. I know I keep going on about it, but this place is huge. The ruins go on for hundreds of miles. Hundreds. Holy shit. Excuse me, General, but I'm sorry. Just made visual contact with a large body of water.
Captain Death, I have visual on some larger structures.
Roger, pilot, I see him. General, we're coming up on, well, kinda looks like a warehouse or a factory.
Captain, structures are occupied. Repeat, occupied.
Go ahead, Joey, but take it slow. I want a closer look.
Roger, Captain. Proceeding.
Seeing some impressive stuff here, General. Place looks to be in good repair and well-maintained. Fresh coat of paint and everything.
Captain, clean visual on bogies.
Coordinates, pilot. Coordinates.
On your nine, Captain.
Robots. Well, shut my mouth. General, we got eyes on the bogies in the compound, and they're robots. Big robots.
Tell them to get out of there, Mer-Captain.
Yes, General. Chopper One, pull out.
Captain, we are being targeted.
10-4, pilot. Hard away north.
Bogies firing, Captain!
West 2 Point. Climb! Climb!
Still on our tail, Captain. It's like they're following us.
Jesus fuck, what kind of tech are we dealing with here? Away team, brace for impact. Hold on! Mayday, mayday, we are hit! We're going down!
Angela! Rangers, I cannot express the grief I'm feeling at this moment. To hear,
oh,
forgive
God.
Me. I don't know who did this or why, but I will not allow it to turn us from our mission. Team Echo, you will fly to the base Team Foxtrot established in Santa Fe Springs. Secondly, you have two primary tactical objectives. First, you will look for the source of the God's Militia and Children of the Citadel broadcast. Finally, but perhaps most importantly, you will do your best to win the hearts and minds of the LA natives, and by your actions, convince them to trust the Desert Rangers. It'll take us some time to put together all the supplies needed for your journey. So if you have any unfinished business in Arizona, that's all I have to say. Any questions? Watch out for that group. They seem to be calling for open warfare against the rest of the world. We don't know much about them except that they seem to be led by a madman who believes that man and machine should become one. That's fantastic, Echo One. The way Danforth was barking about us being child killers and monsters, I didn't think there was any peaceful way out. Echo One, your congratulations, Echo One. Report to the helicopter pad when you are ready, and we'll send you on your way. Dismissed.
Hammer will strike against the Daughter of Stars. Redbirds will fly out of the east and destroy Vegas in the night.
Hi, everybody. This is Corex from the Corex Arcade. Come play my games. I've got them all. Donkey Punch, Whack-A-Plumber, Gagala, Loser Marbles, Vase Invaders, and every kind of system, too. Except a CDI machine. I really...
Okay. Time's up. You've had your turn.
But I paid for 15 seconds. You said I could have 15 seconds on the radio.
That was 15. Max.
Oh, rats.
Great God is barren, but his child waits to the east. Mad-eyed charlatans worship at the altar of an empty faith, but their salvation is on another track.
That guy's like some kind of crazy wizard. Wild!
That should work.
Whoa! Look at all these...
Oh. Good to see you. Welcome back, Echo. Well, the General keeps a tight grip on requisition orders. All of the officers we serve. Nicest guy. We have everything from sturdy leather. I've got some custom, interesting armor. Thanks for visiting, recruits. Come by anytime.
She sure is.
Or perhaps.
Knowledgeable, perspicacious, learned, smart.
Truly, the Thunderbird lives.
About time, Rangers. Ready to fight and get on board.
No time for introductions, Echo One. Stop staring and start blasting. These dogs have got us by the balls.
Canine, dog!
Sons of bitches, couldn't have got here 5 minutes.
Okay, listen up, Echo One. If you don't want to see a replay of what just happened, you need to secure the perimeter of this cheese box and keep out those dogs. No, wait. First, you need to find Woodson and see if he's still alive. He was in our radio room when that pack showed up. I'll be goddamned if I'm gonna see the last man under my command die. But he went out to try to raise you on the straight north from here. Get going. Other than they chewed our asses, this place is like a sieve. They used to call me that because of these hand cannons I carry. Now maybe that's the sad truth. Ranger Team Foxtrot reporting. Dunno. Haven't looked.
That looks mortal, fatal, traumatic, bad.
Perforated intestines, huh? Isn't that pretty much the end of the road? Internal bleeding, infection, lights out killer? Nice of you to lie, Doc. But I know what's what.
Can anybody hear me? I'm out of ammo! Need an assist! Who's out there? That you, Carlson? Let me get the door. Echo team, you made it. Good thing you showed up when you did. I was gonna have to go tooth and nail with those dogs if they made it through the door. What? Only Carson survived? The rest are dead? Oh, fuck. Appreciate it. General Vargas pinned me himself right before we left for California. Rest assured, I'm gonna do my best. Well, I gotta get this radio back. Before I put one in his brain, that dog tore my wires up something fierce. What? Dying? They've been roaming around the outskirts of this place since we got here. Seems like it was a big water treatment plant once upon a time. Echo One, I'm giving several congratulations, Echo One. Keep your ears on. I'll ping you as soon as I
cool
get
you stand behind
crap
me, taking the
running
calls when all the glory's
Rangers,
on the
I over here. You found Woodson, eh? He's all right. Good news. Now get on that perimeter before we have another attack. Don't want any company when I die. How's it coming, Rangers? You seal up all those holes yet? Well, get it in gear. I'm not gonna rest in peace before it's done.
Get an idea what's out there. This is that nut job we were picking up back in Arizona.
Downtrodden of Los Angeles. This is Matthias. Let me help you. I know how hard your legs are. Your muscles ache. Your bones break. Disease weakens you. You have nothing to look forward to as you grow older. Pain. Yeah.
Echo 1, Santa Fe base. Got another patch through for you. These jokers are the gods.
Let us talk today about sin, brothers and sisters. I know all of you out there in the cesspit you call Hollywood think that we up here on the hill believe ourselves better than you. That we think you down there are all sinners, and we up here are all saints. Well, friends, nothing could be further from the truth. We are all sinners, us as well as you. We are all in the midst of the thousand-year tribulation when only the damned walk the earth. Those without sin left this world in the rapture 150 years ago. And we are the cursed children of the corrupted fools who got left behind.
Echo 1, Santa Fe base. They're called the Manorites.
Hello, Los Angeles. Today, with your kind permission, I'd like to put aside our usual call-in format and talk to you about what we're up to down here at the Angel Oracle. Some see our grand edifice and wonder if we're a cult. Some see our martial politeness patrols and wonder if we're a gang. Others express confusion about our message, mistaking our civility and gentility for pacifism. Well, let me put all that to rest. We are not a cult. We are not a gang. And while it is true that we try to be kind and considerate people, that does not mean we let the uncouth and ungracious walk all over us. That kind of rudeness will not be tolerated, and we have the guns to express our...
Echo 1, this is Santa Fe base. Found another frequency. Don't know who this crankcase is, but near as I can tell, his name is Dugan.
Pathetic meatbags of Los Angeles, listen to your overlord. No one can save you from being ground beneath the iron shod feet of my robot army. The Manorites cannot save you. The God's militia cannot save you. And that blind half-man who calls himself Matthias certainly cannot save you. Only immediate and total obedience to my commands will spare you the fate that awaits the rest of humanity. Its utter and complete destruction. I, Dugan, shall rule the future. I, Dugan, shall be master of an earth free from the poison of all biological life. I will exterminate everything, from the mightiest trees to the smallest microbes. All will be expunged, until this planet is nothing more than one great warring factory for the building of a world. That's right, there is no hope for any of you. But if you want to prolong your miserable lives for as long as I will allow, then bring the offerings of steel, iron, wire, electronics, my factory near the port of Los Angeles and leave them at the edge of the radiation.
Listen, Echo One, one more Santa Fe.
Rangers. There. About time you closed those gaps. Wasn't sure I was gonna hold on till you were through. Now, anything you want to ask before I... Guessing they're all dead. Heard the same thing you heard in Arizona. The flyover, the robots, the missile. Strong. Even with the rad suits, Captain Mayor Captain, provided the radiation was too intense. I'm afraid I don't know any more than you do. They're ruthless. Even more so than humans. Pretty basic. First off, you're gonna need to upgrade your rad suits in order to make your way around California. So ask Woodson for the details. Second, hook up a repeater unit to the radio tower at Griffith so we can re-establish a contact with Citadel Base. Third.
Echo One, do you read me? 10-4, Echo One. Good copy on this end. Attention, citizens of Los Angeles. Desert Ranger. Well, there it is, Rangers. And if anybody responds, Santa Fe.